soup, apache, palm nut soup, wehonyu, peanut butter soup, nkating kwang. Is that right? Okro soup, fetridechi, momui honyu. Soup is soup. Yesterday, the goat decided to leave the soup. The other day, the dry snail snailed itself into the stew because the soup was not light enough. Light soup. And krakra was not light enough. Tomorrow, that confused pretender called Kobe and the other one called Tolo Bifi, garden something. They've all decided to jump out of the soup. But guess what? The soup is still soup. The soup is still soup. And you ate it, licked your fingers, you sat back, and you rubbed the belly. And you rubbed the belly and licked your fingers because soup is still soup. Thank you.
Ah, if you are doing it, do it much more better. Do it much more better for our own Vice Chancellor. Ah. Thank you. Thank you, Professor Puplampu. Maybe off record. And all protocols observed. You know, you cannot be Puplampu and not know how to recite or write poems. The name itself rhymes, Puplampu. Put your hands together for Professor Puplampu for that performance. Shortly, we are getting to more performances, and our guest poet is getting set, but before he does, before we get to that meet, let's invite our own again, Hakeem, to give us some jazz performance. Put our hands together for Hakeem. Thank you. Keep clapping until you hear my voice proper. Poetry as song, and song as poetry. That is the theme we are running with for this particular evening's program. We have reached a point where we're going to shortly listen to our guest poet, who has traveled from very far place. Indeed, when you're coming to Central University, and you're in all the traffic, and you arrive, you know you have come from far, and you have come home. I'm sure you are enjoying the ambience of all of this quiet environment as we enjoy poetry and jazz performance. Doing us the honors of properly introducing our guest poet. Once again, let's invite our own Vice Chancellor as he welcomes and receives our guest poet for the evening. Please, for this one, give us a proper hand clap. Proper one. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It is my honor to introduce to us this evening our guest, senior poet, professor, scholar, writer, and man of many parts, Professor Kofi Anyidoho. Forgive me, I've got to take off my glasses because I don't need them to read, although I know I look a little different. Poet, literary scholar, educator, cultural activist. Professor Kofi Anyidoho is currently teaching at the English Department of the University of Ghana, where he retired as a professor of literature. He was the first occupant of the Kwame Nkrumah Chair in African Studies. His training as a professional teacher at the Accra Training College and Advanced Teacher Training College, Winneba, and taught primary, middle, and secondary schools before joining faculty at the university. He has been deeply involved in various initiatives designed to promote African culture and history. Among them, Ghana Television's African Heritage Series, for which he was the main host and executive producer. He holds BA honors in English and Linguistics from the University of Ghana, MA in Folklore from Indiana, Bloomington, and PhD in Comparative Literature from the University of Texas at Austin. His published creative works include collections in poetry, Elegy of the Revolution, Harvest of Our Dreams, Earth Child, Ancestral Logic, and Caribbean Blues. Praise Song for the Land, The Place We Call Home, and others. He is widely known internationally as one of the few bilingual African writers who writes competently in both colonial heritage language and his own mother tongue. As a singer poet, whose voice alternates with that of his late mother, Abla Adidi Anyidoho, herself a poet cantor in the Anglo Ewe oral tradition. His Gananya with Agbeno Hevi is scheduled to be released in print and with the audio recordings by the Bureau of Ghana Languages very, very soon. Akpoklo in Ewe is also expected to be published very soon. As a research scholar, Professor Anyidoho's work is dedicated to interdisciplinary studies. He has published several journal articles and books. And he has served on several editorial boards of many, many journals, General Faculty of Arts, Research Review, Research in African Literatures, and many others. Professor Anyidoho is past president of the US-based African Literature Association, and has served on numerous boards and committees, including the University of Ghana Council, National Commission on Culture, National Theatre Board, National Folklore Board of Trustees, Management Committee on Copyright Administration, the Dubois Memorial Center for Pan-African Culture, Board of Directors, International Advisory Board, Commonwealth Writers Prize, Board of Directors, Panafest Advisory Board. In fact, I could go on. He's known for many, many different poems and has won many prizes from across the world. It is my pleasure and my honor this evening to introduce to us Professor Kofi Anyidoho and to ask him to speak with us in poetry and in song. Professor, sir, thank you.
Wamaha miyajiga wala miyandagae. Ada ulalu. Wamaha miyajiga wala miyandagae. Ada ulalu. Adaula Shima Babumwe Adaula Shima Babumwe Ya Togiwe Flanyigbaya Mielaji Ya Mamawe Flanyigbaya Mielaji Lo Adaula Lo. This song of ours we shall sing and sing until they throw us into jail. Our ancestors fought for this land and bequeathed it to us. So we shall sing and sing until they throw us into jail. Here on this public square, I stand or rather sit. I sell my song for those with ears to buy. It is to a tree that a bull is tied, and you do not bypass the palm's branches to tap its wine. The things I have to say, I'll say them now. Then I shall stand aside for those who care to clear their throats and dress their shame in lies. When you meet a poor neighbor at a public square, you do not spit on the ground and roll your eyes to the skies. The umbrella I bought, you stole it away from my room at dawn. And now I walk in the early morning rain, and you point me out to the young maidens, and they join you in laughter. Think, my people, think. Think well before you laugh at those who walk in the rain. That poem, opening poem, is not entirely my poem. Part of it composed by an oral poet in our tradition, and I build on it because our people say it is onto the old ropes that new ones are woven. Poetry as song, song as poetry. So the same saying you will hear in one of the most classic Agbaja songs. Agbodala komene dolu, kahoho ngwaye odo e, godala komene doye, kahoho. It is unto the old ropes that new ones are woven. I'm almost sure that every one of us here, even the children, they know of that neighbor, that sister, that aunt who has been abandoned by a lover, a husband, who claims he's traveling far and wide to bring something good home. The only problem is that sometimes too often they never come back. You know of a brother, a twin brother, who has traveled leaving behind the other twin brother to face all the problems alone. One of my earliest poems, The Song of the Twin Brother, dedicated to Kofi Anyidoho. Stand unshod upon the terrazzo floors of your balcony. Look over the barricade to the savannah grasslands of your countryside. And silence the stereo sounds of your radiogram and open your soul to the mellow tones of your brother's, country brother's xylophone. So many, many moons ago, before our world grew old, I had a twin brother. We shared the same mat, but dreamt of worlds apart. And so, here I am today, holding on to grandfather's sinking boat, While I do, my twin brother floats on air in jumbo jets. And dreams of foreign skies. Floats on air in jumbo jets, stares into the skies and dreams of foreign ports. Achue, Achule, do not forget the back without which there is no front. Do not forget the back without which there is no front. Dada, our mother, is still alive. But grown silent and full of songs, sang in a voice that hints of a heart overstrained with the burdens of a clan without elders. You know, our roof is now a sieve, Achu. The rains beat us. They beat us, even in our dreams. And the gods, they say, are not to blame. The state farms have burned the thatch and dug its roots. They grow rice and cane sugar, but oh, Achu, my twin brother, Achu, our bowels are not made for the tasty things of life. The rice, the sugar, all go to Accra for people with clean stomachs and silver teeth to eat and expand in their borrowed glory. Achue, Achule, I shall give your name to the wind. They will roam the world for you. You forget, Achu, my father's former son, you forget the back without which there is no front. Papa has lost his war against hernia. And 7 Kata Market days ago, we gave him back to the soil. And so now Dada is full of Nyaito songs, sorrowing songs sung in a voice whose echoes float into the morning chambers of your soul. Achu, Dada says the tasty things of life are good, but you do not chase fortune beyond the point where old sky bends down to have a word with earth. You do not bury your arm in fortune's hole. There have been others before, Achu. There have been others before you. Amato went away. Then he never came. Katakotu went away, but came and went again then. Came back without his soul. Achu, I sit under this oak where you and I once sat and cast cowries in the sand. I close my eyes and I give your name to the winds. They will roam the world and find your ears. Papa has gone to Chepe. Ada is full of Nyaito songs, and I, Eche, your twin brother, my heart overflows with unsung dirges. Oh, many, many moons ago, before the silence came, I had a twin brother. We shared the same mat, but parted in our dreams. Song as poetry, poetry as song. So what do you do with Achu gone? Father gone, Dada full of what?
Deji's. You sit down alone and you give it to song. You give it to song. Aome soafeolo nai dumenyome soafeo ofai tokula mbo ndiche fwame nome la mesio edofuye wame ovimenye dojikola Aho miwe na mlo dumenyume so apu ofai. Please call him for me. Dumenyume so apu. A beautiful, prosperous land can never equal your own. Father gone, you are beaten by the morning rain. Mother gone, you are eaten up by hunger. Please, come home. Come home. Come home. Agbeno heavy. Agbeno. Heavy. A number of my poems are built around statements from our oral tradition, like proverbs. This one, Agbeno Heavy, Megba Fumato, unless the bird dies young. It shall surely grow feathers one day. This poem, Agbeno Heavy, has been gone for too long, leaving behind a lover who's been waiting, waiting, and waiting. There is a recurring line here in which I'd like you to join me in an interactive fashion. Simply, come back home. Agbeno Heavy, come back home. Can we try that? Come back home. Agbeno Heavy, come back home. A week today at carnival time, young men of the land will gather for the wrestling duel of song and dance. Maidens will sharpen their tongues and carve praise images of dream lovers, and I have a god full of praise names laid aside for you. So please, come back home. Agbeno Heavy, come back home. In the eyes of town, I will break the evil glance of witches. I will pour you a calabash of pride. I will hold it firm to your lips till your eyes catch the gleam of stars, till your mind reaches out for moons, till your body vibrates to rhythms of the seas. So please, come back home. Agbeno Heavy, come back home. And your voice shall rise deep across the years through rainbow gates to beginnings of things. It will come floating through seasons of glory, thundering through deserts and pain fields where our people died the death of droughts and of wars, where they died and lived again, where they die and wake up with seeds of life sprouting from their graves. So please, come back home. Agbanohevi, come back home. Agbanohevi, Achu Agbanohevi, I have held my passion in check for you, holding it fast against storms, against thunder, held it firm against the haunting smiles of gods. I have strained my bosom against the sharp edges of Hamatan winds, against the rumbling weight of May rainstorms. You know, I am the rainbow standing guard across your path of storms. Achu, I have died 100 deaths for you. And each time, each night, I wake up again and again in that house we built upon the shores with pools of troubled seas. Come back home, Agbanohevi, come back home. You know, all my peers now carry big babies on their back. Still, I carry mine in my heart, sometimes in my loins. And oh, she cries so much for you. Please, come back home, Agbanohevi, come back home. You know, Kokui, my young sister, went away last moon at harvest time. She swallowed a tiny gourd seed, and so now she carries a giant gourd in her belly for Senyo, our dying chief's only living son. Even Foli, my mother's youngest child, now speaks in the broken voice of a man-child. They say at the village school, he goes pinching all the bigger girls on their wosso-wossos. They always scream, but they never report him. And once the teacher caught him, he says, you know, he said, oh, it was just a little test to hear the difference in voice pitches of teenage girls and teenage boys. They let him off, and now he comes boasting he's man enough to handle 1,000 meddling teachers. He even talks to me of a sweet madness that may be in these words I give to the winds for you. So please, come back home. Agbanohevi, come back home. I have woven 100 songs for you, woven them all into pillows for your wandering head of dreams. For your bed, I plucked feathers from the peacock's pride, and each midnight, moonlight night, I walked naked to the crossroads towards the setting place of sun. I leaned against the firm bosom of our ancient baobab tree. I closed my eyes. I give your name to the westbound winds. And in a careless abandon to joys there are in songs, I stretch my breast against the moon's glory, just waiting, waiting to dance you home to your rainbow bed, where you and I may wrestle again, all over again, in that old fertility game first played by the gods in the seed time of our earth. I say today I stand naked beneath our ancient baobab tree, watching your dreams running along the path of storms. I will woo you yet with glories of the moon, while our hunters break their tongues in strange whispers of moon deity at life's crossroads, keeping vigil for sun god's homecoming from ramblings across the skies, through thunder's gates and lightning's path into the house of fugitive dreams. So please, come back home, Agbanohevi. Come with me to your rainbow bed where you and I shall wrestle again and again, all over again, in that old fertility game first played by the gods in the seed time of our earth. Just come back home, Agbanohevi. Come back home. Ah, Milonamlo, chenu mele jinamiu, chenu mewa, chenu me nyamiu, nuka mewa ve chenu me nyam, oa o, milonam lo, mawewe, kunone nani. It's God's will that even a childless woman must live. So what exactly have I done that you don't have any love for me? Please, spare a little love for me, will you? Just a little. I'm not asking for too much. Do not give too much of your love to me. Do you hear that? Do not give too much of your love to me. I am the bird with voice of dreams. I bring the brief glory of wings upon the rays. Long ago, I chose a rainbow for my soul. I am the bird in flight, the arrow through your night. Do not give too much of your love to me. Once the angels stole my cloth somewhere upon the clouds in the house of stones. Today I sweep the sky, I leave footprints on the thunder clouds, I spread the swift glory of wings upon the rays. Oh, do not give too much of your love to me. You do so at your own. I must pay homage to the eagle. I'm sitting under the protective wings of the eagle. Once upon a time, we lost to death a man who was an air marshal, Air Marshal Harry Dumashi, who was the head of our armed forces. And I was asked to write a tribute poem for him, The Lament of the Eagle. When the elders see the vulture perch upon the royal palm, they must tremble their beards in memory of the eagle's pride. Hadada Taibo in Achev, he said it once in song. Some bird has snatched eagle, a bird with name unknown has caught eagle and dropped him among vultures. So often in my time, I flew the skies and swam against the storm. So often in my days, I combed the clouds and caught the lightning in my eyes. I rode the winds and gathered thunder in my voice. So often in my youth, I dared the sun and caught the rainbow in my smile. So often in my prime, I climbed the moon and looked the sun in the face. But now, let the vulture trample on my fame and cast shadows upon my royal name. Let the rainstorms rumble through my house and shake the ancestral baobab to its roots. My heart has grown beyond the reach of joys. My breath has flown beyond the reach of words. I am now a lone traveler, lost among shadows. At my back, I can hear the wailing call. I can count the sorrow songs. I can feel, I can smell, I can touch the dying breath. But Kuchemi Salagachi says, the road ahead is longer than the road behind. So I must fly in the dawn so I can reach home with the sun. I must climb the rising winds to catch the falling stars. I must swim the shadows now so to harvest the blazing light. So let the vulture dance upon our royal palm. I, Akpabli Hosu, who once looked the sun in the eye and caught the lightning in my smile and gathered thunder in my voice. I, Akpabli Hosu, I must now close my eyes to the dazzling beauty of dawn. I must shut my mouth to the bugle's farewell call to arm. We will return to song again and again and again. Some of the most powerful poetry is found in our traditional song. Suppose you are about to go on a journey. Some people in our traditions will consult a diviner. Today, many of us may go and seek at least a blessing of our pastor. Suppose you go to consult a diviner, and the diviner performs a little ritual and sings the following song. He shakes his head. Sawolie ble na obe bela fima mengayu. Sawolie ble na obe bela fima mengayu. Sawolie ble na obe bela fima mengayu. Saulie ble nao, abela fima ben, veala fima vahohoe, abela fima mengai, barela fima vahohoe, abela fima mengaiu. Saulie ble nao, abela fima mengaiu. Saulie ble nao, abela. Sawoli, one of the divinities in the Afar tradition, says, where you are going, there is a hole there. Don't go. Where you are heading, there is a hole, a gulf. Don't go. The hole there is an ancient one. Don't go. But of course, if you like, you can go. If you like, you can go. But Afar is built on a simple principle that there is nothing that happens to you today or happened to you yesterday or will happen to you tomorrow which has never happened in the life of humanity. So Afar builds up a comprehensive corpus of human experience. And when you consult the diviner will go into Afar and advise you. Don't go. There is a deep hole there. But of course, today, we would say Afar is talking nonsense. And then you go and find out for yourself. I've heard a few love poems here this evening. And our people too sing about love. Who was a gentleman who paid glowing tribute to somebody here a little while ago? Let's pray that everything goes well. Otherwise, you might find yourself singing the following song. Oh, Olagbe, Lolo, Olagbe, Bembe, Olagbe, Jinye, Olagbe. Oh, Olagbe, Lolo, Olagbe. Ajibe ijo ulagbe ma volemu. My love, are you well? Are you alive this morning? You say you are gone, but I can't help thinking of you. So are you by any chance doing well this morning? Aweke nyeke lo, awajie weke nyeke lo, ajime lonu le bonye wa o nyeke le wawale, lonlome lonu le bonye uje nyeke le wawale. But it could be a happy song. Lolova vandele. Machona o lolova vandele menye. Machona o. Agbeye yarele menye. Machona o lolova vandele menye. Machona o. Jijova vandele menye. Machona o. I have this beautiful, beautiful happiness in me, and I'd like to share it with you. This great love. So you can add that to your poem. I'd like you to follow me on a short journey. That will take us back into a bit of our history, a not so happy part of our history. A bit of that was already shared with you earlier, what I call the journey into soul time through the stampede of the slave trade. A journey into soul time through the stampede of the slave trade. Our young people here, we don't teach them about it. We don't tell them about it. But once upon a time, when you leave home in the morning to go to the farm, you couldn't be so sure that you come back home. And if you did in fact come back home, you couldn't be too sure that the people you left back will be there, that your family, your wife and children will be there. Memory and vision. Memory and vision. We are dancer and the dance. Time before memory. Memory beyond time. We harvest tears from laughter's eyes. You know, we even sow some joy in sorrow's deepest soul. We are dancer and the dance. In the space between the drums and us, you will feel unfold the endless saga of ancestral time. We are dancer in the dance. Amene dwasya gujilo yo. Amene dwasya gujilo yo. Yowe dwasya gujilo yo. Who was it that placed their hands upon our dawn and stopped it from breaking into daylight? Amere noasia gujilu uyu. Yowe noasia gujilu aguma. There is a journey we all must make into our past in order to come to terms with our future. You know, for 500 years and more, we have journeyed into various spaces of this earth. And everywhere we go, we must confront dimensions of ourselves we did not know were there. There is something of our story, something of our mystery, carved into every tombstone in all the graveyards of the world. Something of our history, enshrined in every monument and in every anthem ever erected in honor of the spirit of endurance. Back home here, here in Africa, here in Ghana, here in Zimbabwe, here in Africa, we perform our resurrection dance in the company of hyenas pretending to be royal ancestors. Hyenas pretending to be royal ancestors. So some tell us that our salvation lies in a repudiation of ourselves, a repudiation of our history of pain, our history of shame, our history of endless fragmentation. But you know, we must wander through history into myth and memory, seeking lost landmarks in a geography of scars and of tormented remembrances. It cannot, must not be that the rest of the world came upon us, picked us up, used us to clean up their mess, then dropped us off into trash and moved on into new eras of celebrative arrogance, hopeful, somehow hopeful that we shall forever remain lost among shadows of our own doubts, lost forever among shadows of our own doubts. You know, ours is the intro blues, the forever journey into soul time. It is a quest for a future alive with the energy of recovered vision, a future released from the trauma of a cyclonic past and from the myopia of a stampeded present. With so much waiting to be undone, with so much left so long undone, to keep calling our situation a dilemma is just a bad excuse for inaction. Somehow we must recall that we are a people who once rode civilization, rode the dawn with civilization's light still glowing through our mind. And so if today we seem lost among shadows, we must probe the deep night of our blood and seek out our birth cord from the garbage heap of history's crowded lies. A people once enslaved, they say, are too often too willing to be a people self-enslaved. Always we must recall the fate of those who fought to the death of the last warrior. They fought and fought to the death and the resurrection of the final hope. So they wiped them out, drowned their screams, burned their nerves and bones, and gathered and scattered their ashes across the intimidating splendor of this young history of lies. And so the Asante, the Azande, and the Mande, the Madingo and the Bakongo, the Basutu, the Dagaba, and the Dogon, a people who once bold civilizations of rare glory are now but doubtful memories on the faded pages of world history. And so for 500 years and more, we have journeyed from Africa through the Virgin Islands into Santo Domingo, from Havana in Cuba to Savannah in Georgia, from voodoo shores of Haiti to Montego Bay in Jamaica, from Ghana to Guyana, from the shanty towns of Johannesburg to the favelas in Rio de Janeiro, from Bochum to Harlem to Brixton, from Hamburg to Moscow to Kyoto, and all we find are a dispossessed and battered people still kneeling in a sea of blood, lying deep in the path of hurricanes. But no matter how far away we try to hide away from ourselves, we will have to come back home and find out where and how and why we lost the light in our eyes, how and why we have become eternal orphans living on crumbs and leftovers. You know, we are the dog who caught the game, but now must sit under the table, cracking our hopes over bones and over droppings from the master's hands. But you know, in spite of all that pain, we can say without a doubt that as a people, we do hold the world record for survival against the most unreasonable odds. Yes, we hold the most spectacular survival record. But we must hasten to remind ourselves that just to survive, simply to survive, merely to survive, barely to survive, is not and can never be enough. And so still, we stand so